G'day ice cream lovers, my name's Steve Christensen. Welcome back post-Christmas edition of the Scoop School Sessions. Nice to have you here, broadcasting from St. Louis, Missouri. Hope you all had a lovely holiday. I myself had a wonderful holiday, unshaven, seeing how long I can get without the whole beard being requested to be shaved off. Nonetheless, great to be here. Very thankful for our episode sponsor, which is Frozen Dessert Supplies. New sponsor, the lads up in Idaho are making cups, spoons, all sorts of things for the ice cream business. If you want a specific cup, if you wanted a custom printed cup, Frozen Dessert Supplies, funnily enough, their website is frozendessertsupplies.com, and their link is down below. Click on it, tell them that Steve mentioned you in the video, and who knows what loving you might get from the Frozen Dessert Supplies folks. That's not what we're talking about today. We are talking about water in fruit, and what are the best fruits to make ice cream with. It's a conundrum. We've had one of our viewers likes the word conundrum. We try and throw it in every now and again. It's one of the conundrums that ice cream makers have because they want to make a fruit-based ice cream, but the water in that fruit works really against you in the mouthfeel process and in the freezing process. I have here a percentage chart, water amounts in fruit and vegetables. Interestingly enough, it was created to help you stay more hydrated. The problem is that we want the delicious flavor. We don't want the hydration in our ice cream. So can you guess what the number one on the list for the highest percentage of water in fruit is? You would be correct if you said watermelon. Watermelon and strawberry, 92% water. Would you believe it? 92% water. Throwback to Maxwell Smart. Would you believe it? Would you believe it if I said, anyway, 92% water. So the problem is that if you want to make a strawberry ice cream, a watermelon ice cream, you've got a really high amount of water, which plays havoc with not only the freezability of it, scoopability of it, but the mouthfeel as well. Some of the other very high in water fruits, grapefruit, cantaloupe, peach, cranberries, and orange. And as you get down the list, you get down to this kind of area where grapes and bananas are 74% water. So as you go lower in water content, the easier it is to freeze and you get a little bit more mouthfeel. You don't get that icy texture. The higher in water content, so your strawberries, your watermelon, grapefruits, and so forth, they're probably better suited for a sorbet or a water-based product rather than for ice cream. Now, how do you process that? We've had other videos on there on that topic. Basically, it's you need to masticate it, so you need to drench the fruit with sugar, which will draw out the water, make a simple syrup. But again, the problem is you may have eliminated the iciness of the water with the simple syrup or the sugar mixing with the strawberry, but then you have problems with too much sugar means that it depresses the freezing point and it's harder to freeze. It's always a conundrum. Everyone wants to use fresh fruit. They don't want to use a jam or a paste or something that's been overly prepared and cooked, but you've got that icy texture. One thing I would do if you're going to do one of those high in water content fruits is to basically, after you sugar them, strain them. Because again, even that pulp is going to maintain some water content and be icy in the ice cream. The lower the water content of the fruit, the better it's going to freeze, the better it's going to scoop, and the better mouthfeel you're going to get. So use sugar appropriately. And that's about all we have for this video. Thank you very much again for our sponsor, Frozen Dessert Supplies. Check them out. Hey, we love comments. Love comments. And a lot of the topics that we have for these videos, we take from the comments. So leave a comment down below. Smash like now. Hit the little bell. Keep on scooping. We'll see you in the next video.